Thank you. It is beautiful. It is a dialogue.
Yeah.
The male principle, the female principle,
yeah.
And it is interesting to analyze the Hindu music because it's full of signification. It is you are singing in the harmonium continuous sounds. The basis of a life is continuity. So this is it exists in Hindu music. In European music, I think the continuity is not so clear. You see, it's always rhythm. But here is the continuity and the dialogue.
Yeah.
It's very interesting.
And the joy. Yeah,
the joy. Yeah? Yes, joy. Yes. This is the joy. You are not professional singers. And this is very important.
Yeah.
So to be able to sing with joy, the joy, it's the foundation of all singing. And not to make an industry or to professionalize you in this field. It is,
yeah. And one more point, singing these mantras is very good for the health, mentally, physically, and the whole body enjoys with the singing.
Yes.
It's a very, research was done on this, and they found that in singing a few mantras or in a chorus or playing the keyboard, it's very good for the mental and physical system.
Beyond all kind of religious of cultural signification of a mantra represents, I read some psychological research about it, and the mantra, it is a kind of unity of a single representation, visual or acoustic, doesn't matter. But when you say the mantra, it's only one piece of mental activity, so it's not a process. So it's very important to use our mind to leave the process of thinking, and to rest only in one piece of mental phenomena.
Yeah, and why we singing in the Sanskrit language? Because the Sanskrit sounds, they are very profound and they are connected with our soul quality. So that makes the purification even more effective from a deep level. That's why we're using the Sanskrit. Even our body process is consisting of this 52 Sanskrit syllables. And then we're talking about the energy centra, the chakras. Every energy center is connected with some of the syllables. So it's giving a very deep, profound effect on our system.
So Sanskrit, it's a special code, that's a language code. We cannot compare Sanskrit with, let's say, French or English.
No.
It is much more older.
Much more older, and they now also found that it is the most perfect language in the computer technology, because of its purity and its systematical development. Every sound has a special, and sound and form are also connected to each other.
It is interesting. So some we know that German, it is the language of philosophy. And so Sanskrit, it's the language of the soul. Of
they call it Devanagari. Devanagari means the language of the gods.
Language of the gods.
So it's a kind of holy language, you could say, and divine language, and the language of the gods.
Yeah, and I was thinking now, but there, it's also the Tibetan language, and there are some other very profound languages. What is the relation between them?
Well, Tibetan language is very much connected to the Sanskrit. Many words are exactly the same, or a little bit different. So there are, of course, more very qualified languages. Mm-hmm. Even the Romanian language is a very, very nice and, mm-hmm. and very beautiful language. Mm-hmm. But you could say that all the languages, and the mother of all the languages is the Sanskrit.
Sanskrit.
Language.